Service agents use our tools a lot, sometimes for their entire shift, so we have put a ton of thought and research into the design and UI of InvGate Service Desk. Let me show it off a little bit. Hi, Matt Barron, product specialist at InvGate. With InvGate Service Desk, you can make your agents more powerful. With a few clicks, they can take action and move on to their next work. Before we get started, you can always grab a trial instance of our software at try.invgate.com and follow along. Are you an agent who likes to see the big picture, or a service desk manager who wants to see the whole picture? Our dashboard feature is great for seeing the big picture. You can customize it to your heart's content by simply adding in things. So I can add in rows. In rows, I can add columns and set up individual charts and customize it to my heart's content. I can also take these dashboards and share them out with other users, even unlicensed colleagues. The next big area for agents is the My Work section. This section is built to present the most pressing work first. Here you can see we use colors to indicate which tickets are awaiting my actions. Red means that it's my job to act next, while orange and the cooler colors indicate work that is waiting on customers or approvals or something else. You'll also notice that we put the SLAs right on the ticket. This makes it easy for agents to see how much time I have to respond, 8 minutes here, and how much time I have to resolve tickets. This view is customizable to show it as a list or as cards. We want agents to be powerful, so we made it so that you can click on a ticket and quickly change the status on waiting for a date or a customer, as well as taking actions here on the right. These actions are more like responses. Maybe this is a spam and we need to just reject it. These two are maybe duplicates, so we can merge them together. The escalate option makes it easy so that teams can set up auto-escalation routes based on the category or request type. This way, new agents don't have to know who to assign work to. They can just escalate as needed and get back to resolving what they know how to resolve. Once we get into the ticket, we see a lot more data. And that's something you'll love about InvGate Service Desk. No more hunting and clicking through tabs to find information. All the ticket information is available right here. In the interest of making agents as powerful as possible, we give lots of options for handling the structure of work. First, the same options exist here so you can set it to awaiting a user or a vendor, and over here too so I can merge, duplicate, and reject requests. But then, we also add a visual indicator here to show who owned the ticket and for how long, and we provide additional tools to then add structure to this work. Maybe we just need a quick reminder in an hour or so to come back to this work. Or maybe there are some subtasks that need to be done first, so we need to set up the RMA in the shipping system and generate a pickup slip. These subtasks can be assigned out to my teammates or to me. They can have due dates and descriptions. Tons of useful features in the subtasks. Here's a unique one. Maybe I need an approval on this ticket. Maybe we're just gonna spend $4,000 on a piece of software. So I need to make sure that someone can approve it. And maybe this is my manager. But you can quickly add approvals and a description to say, reassignments are an obvious one because, of course, we need to reassign work all the time. This allows you to pick the team and the person, as well as providing an internal comment to let them know why you're reassigning it. And speaking of time, here's a simple way to add time to just every ticket. So if I spent 12 minutes walking to the office or to another cube, I can put that in here. I can also add specific start and end times, as well as a description for why I'm logging time. Down here in the ticket, we've got the full history of the work and automations being performed. And just above all that, we have a dialog box to have a conversation with the customer, or internally if we need to. We've also got options to attach documents, pictures, knowledge articles, and quick canned responses. These canned responses make it super easy to provide simple language, repeatable language, appropriate language, and remove some of the typing that's needed from my agent's workload. So now I did a quick first response, and I'm hitting my SLA for that. Now, over on the right, we see all the people that are participating in the ticket. We also see any related records, so here are some specific relationships that have been set up with this ticket, as well as some CIs, so maybe I have a server or a specific asset that should be associated with this request. I can then link them to this ticket. Below that, we've got the knowledge base, which is going to suggest knowledge articles. All of this information is within easy reach. No hiding, no clicking around on tabs. In the same mindset of making agents powerful, we give everyone the ability to slice and dice their requests however they need. Under the Requests tab, we show you all the lists of data, so I can see unresolved, not assigned work, resolved work, which is of course going to be a large list. But for example, maybe I want to show requests that are awaiting other activities. I can click the plus sign here, and it's going to let me set up some filters. So just show me some things that are in pending or waiting status, and show only the things that are assigned to me. I can quickly create a custom view, and then pin it to my views and save it for later. Lastly, we've got to show off our knowledge base, which is a good way for agents to be able to enter in the knowledge that they have and provide good content to solve problems and help standardize some solutions. It's really quite simple. Agents can come in here and find the right category, set the visibility, and start publishing an article. Once published, all the metrics are viewable in the right-hand column. Here I can see all the markings of useful and not useful, as well as views. And down below, I can see the comments that customers have made on the article. Very useful for improving knowledge articles. And these are just some of the big features in InvGate Service Desk that are designed to make agents powerful and efficient. We've got two more videos of walkthroughs. One for the customer view of the self-service portal, as well as an administrator walkthrough of the settings for Service Desk. So make sure you check those out. For more on this topic, check us out on YouTube or discover our solutions by signing up for a trial at try.invgate.com. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you again soon.